Anderson all the way from Eldora. Do trust you've been thoroughly entertained over the last three nights of Speedway here at Ozdeck Patio's Adsport Speedway, and we are about to shake the hive for 35. Tittman to lead the way, Foley on the outside. Shots. Does he go for it right from the crack of the green? Can Oldfield go with him? Can the national champ match him? Track looking stellar. You've just seen a very entertaining PB44. 35 laps to whet the appetite for the main course. Blake Anderson, this will be a bell ringer.
Oh, this is going to be awesome. 35 on the big board in turn number three. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here at Archer Field Speedway, it's showtime! Rolling through turn number two, down the backstretch, a good battle for that second spot as we try to go three wide for third, but off of turn number four, lap number one, going the books to Kevin Tittman.
Rodolfo looking quick already in the 17, but here comes the king. Johnny Schott's already railed in the 15, got down underneath very quickly, and now he already looks at Oldfield. Does not muck around Blake Anderson.
Schott's wasting no time as he and Shirley roll around the bottom as we go three wide for the fifth spot through the field. This racetrack in phenomenal shape as Brian Mann rolls to the infield, a flat left front on the EMI number 16 car. Right now your leader is Kevin Tittman, but he's got a big one lurking in the background. Luke Oldfield knocking the fence down in turns three and four.
Great battle up front. Tittman's got the Maxwell engine absolutely humming at the moment, but he knows as he looks up on the board and comes down the back straight, he's got the 17 for company. Into three and four, they go right on the top in each other's wheel tracks, Blake.
Boy, it's impressive to see how much smoother the cushion is for the sprint cars in turns one and two. Got a little nervous after watching the mods to see, are the sprints going to be able to run the high side? Well, Luke Oldfield and Kevin Tittman making it look easy, rim riding through one and two.
Look at Schott searching for the moisture up and down the racetrack. Came through here, he'll go down low through one and two. Pick up the momentum again next to the fence, and he is slowly closing him up one lap at a time.
Donnie Schott's one of the most methodical sprint car drivers you will ever see. That's what makes him one of the best. We got a couple of parked in turn number two. It's Brent Kratzman and
Timmy Farrell.
Timmy Farrell, the 51 machine, unfortunately parked. Ooh,
see the brake rotor there.
Brake rotor just a little of Nicky Well, followed by Ryan McNamara with some work to do. Alan
Flat right
Adam
rear.
Butler, yes, flat right rear. Great pickup, Blake Anderson and Alan Solitz. And unfortunately, Corbett will pull it up. I wonder. And lights are out, boys. We got 29 still left, six in the bank. And it has been an absolute ripper of an evening once again at Ozdeck Patio's Archfield Speedway. Happy New Year!
Tittman goes down to the bottom as Oldfield goes right to the fence. Oldfield closing in down the backstretch as Tittman goes to the high side. Now Donnie down to the inside, side by side for the second spot.
The sound, the feel of the V8s, 900 horsepower down underneath the tower. Just letting Ash Media's microphones pick up the sights and sounds. We'll let them go for a lap, Blake Anderson.
Kratzman tapped the outside wall there as tried to knock the Jacobs ladder out of her as that turn four wall gave him some problems the other night. Got way high as we stay clean and green right now. Kevin Tittman running a great race in the 59 car, leading with 25 to go.
Yeah, that's the form that Tittman had at the start of the season and has picked it up again. Kratzman's had enough. His backside's on fire at the moment. And the BK Trading number two machine heads straight to the infield. He'll be out of that as quick as a cat. being scalded by hot water. I can tell you right now, Tittman now starting to get closed in by Oldfield and Schott. Schott's still going to the bottom side, and Oldfield has not moved out of the wheel tracks of Tittman from the drop of the green.
Leaders starting to close in as the top three start to bunch up a little bit. Top two run the boards as Tittman taps the outside fence, and that might be the opening that Luke Oldfield needs. Oldfield around the high side. You've got a new leader down the back chute.
Oldfield doesn't need an invitation twice. Here comes Schott. He's still sitting down the bottom, just letting the car do the work. Closes in on Tittman. Kevy will be dirty on himself for making the simple little mistake coming out of the turn. But now, the three-car freight train into the slower traffic, Blake. This is where it's going to get interesting.
Well, Tittman had to really slow the car down there to get it to rotate, and it cost Schott dearly. Meanwhile, Andrew Shirley throwing his hat into the ring. How about the Australian champion closing in on Donnie Schott for third?
He's just doing it under the radar tonight, isn't he? Tittman all over the racetrack. That car is not happy. Kevy fighting the wheel as they go down through turns one and two. Shirley can see this, and he's trying to set him up to make the pass on the outside.
1.407 was the distance last time, now 1.474. Luke Oldfield adding to his lead as Donnie Schott tries to negotiate lap traffic.
Schott gets down underneath the KRE machine of McNamara. McNamara puts the foot in the gas, gets away from the King. And once again now, Donnie going to the top. He hasn't done that for a while there in one and two. Having a look at the top side to see if there's any momentum up there, and then switches back to the bottom, coming through three and four.
Oldfield running away from Donnie Schott's lead up to 2.7 seconds at halfway. Luke Oldfield slicing through lap traffic, Steve.
Absolutely, 16 laps to run this time by. Car looking beautiful at the moment. The chairman of the boards up over the bump, switches down underneath the 33 machine of Callum Walker.
Schott's trying to clear McNamara. He'll get clear of him and now try to negotiate through about a four more lap cars. Donnie Schott's starting to feel Luke Oldfield slip through his fingers. Oldfield caught behind a pair of lap cars. Once he gets past them, Steve, he's got a clear track to start to run away.
Absolutely. Foley started on the front row, remember, and is just getting rounded up by Luke Oldfield, the leader of the race, and gets it done. He's put about four cars now between himself and Schott's.
Donnie Schott has four cars now, make it three as he gets past Adam Butler, and the advantage to 2.5 seconds nearly.
Oh, just enjoying the sounds of the big 900 horsepower V8s ripping through the clayway here at Ausdeck Patio's Archfield Speedway. Back to do it on Saturday night for World Series Sprint Cars. No finer sight in motorsport in the world. Oldfield leading. Schott's again starting to close the gap with laps winding down. It'll be 10 to go this time by Blake.
I was just going to say, Donnie Schott. Oh, Luke Oldfield over nearly. And A going incredible.
Not over for Oldfield.
Left rear is going on that guy.
Wow. Just as Donnie Schott was starting to put the whips to her and cut about 1.3 seconds off, Luke Oldfield catches the cushion wrong, and incredible, the 17 didn't end up on its lid. Incredible save.
He'll be absolutely filthy with himself in the 17 machine.
I mean, you look at the big picture though, just man, you gotta be thankful he didn't get upside down, did all big it upside down there.
Absolutely. Tire down on the left-hand side of the car. Bit of debris rolled away from it as it pulled up, so that would have just been rubber flying off the back wheel. Oh, Blake Anderson, another stellar night at Ausdeck Patio's Archfield Speedway, worth $30 to get in.
And Donnie looking for the hat trick to go three in a row.
Beautiful looking motor car, stellar looking effort from the team this year. And Lukey will move away off the race surface.
Shaking his head in disgust in the cockpit, guys, I can tell you that.
I bet he is. And all of a sudden, the national champ is in the house and on the tail tank. of the 10-time World of Outlaw champion, Lukey Oldfield, just climbing out of that machine. Big round of applause for Luke Oldfield, folks. He will be back to fight on Saturday night. And we've got a grandstand finish coming up, Blake Anderson, with 10 laps left to run, because all of a sudden, Tittman wants to go to the top side.
Kevin Tittman's done a nice job staying in the mix. Andrew Shirley, right now, looking for his best run during the International Series. As he sits in the second spot, the Australian champion not letting Donnie Schott slip away. And how about Cody Morosky right there across the nose of Alan Woods, hanging on to the fourth spot.
Yeah, Woodsy wants an invite to the party, the 28 machine. Right in amongst it, and this is the kind of track that Alan Woods loves. Nice, black, flat racetrack. And the SCA 28 machine, all of a sudden, Blake Anderson has come to life.
Alan Woods is on to something. Started 10th, right now runs in the fifth spot, looking for more as Donnie crosses the line with seven to go. Lap traffic still quite a bit away from that Raw Metal Corp number 15 car.
He's just putting on another stellar masterclass, isn't he? Opens up the gap over the national champion down the back straight. Again across the tower, and the gap already has opened up to 2.592 seconds. Not hanging around and giving it a red hot crack.
Boy, this is so reminiscent, Steve, of what we see all year in America. It gets to 10 to go, and Donnie Schott kicks it into high gear. It's like he kind of sits back and waits, saves his equipment, and waits and waits, and then turns on the afterburners, hits the NOS button, and gone away is the 15 car. Donnie Schott leads with four to go.
Shirley sitting in second with Tittman still there in third. Katie Morosky, Alan Woods, that's the top five. Carl Hoffman's great drive in sixth. Brock Dean also in the top 10 sits seventh. Adam Butler, Callum Walker, and Mark Foley. That's the top 10 on the racetrack with three laps left to run, and he's just now doing it in a canter.
Schott negotiates lap traffic. Shirley still rides in the second spot. Kevin Tittman right now in the third spot. Keep in mind, Kevin Tittman leading driver points here at Osdick Patios and Roofing Archerfield Speedway.
Doctor's jacket this time by for the 10-time World of Outlaw champion. Down across the strike, 400 meters left of the Osdick Patios Archerfield Clayway.
Oh, we got one around in turn number two. Ryan McNamara around. Got into the cushion and just turned the 88 around.
One lap left on the board. We watch Frankie. Will they declare it, or will we go back to a green, white checker? The lights are out. We go green this time. Bye, folks. Do trust you've had a fantastic night at Osdick Patios Archerfield Speedway. If you're listening to us on MixLR, do trust you've enjoyed it at home as well. We are back to do it. World Series Sprint Cars Saturday night. Let's go racing one more time with two laps to run.
I think Kevin Tittman was going to try to throw a slider on Andrew Shirley there, but Shirley smartly got down to the bottom, and now Tittman down to the inside. He'll slide up and take second at the white flag. Shirley reads him like a book and dives down to the inside, but Tittman powers away.
Andrew Shirley kissing the cushion, but it's all the king. Checkered flag at the ready. Three starts, Blake Anderson, three wins.
Kevin Tittman second, Andrew Shirley third, Alan Woods fourth, Cody Morosky rounds out the top five.
Carl Hoffman was the next one through with Adam Butler, Brock Dean, Callum Walker, Mark Foley, Christy Bonzi, Nicky Woe, and Ryan McNamara. Blake Anderson, we're on our way down to presentation.
What a drive from him once again, folks. Put your hands together for Donnie Schott. Tell you what, Kevy Tittman there, the luck of the Irish with Kev Tittman tonight. He banged off that wall a couple of times hard tonight, and I'm surprised to still see the 58 running there. And good drive once again from Andrew Shirley as a couple of the boys having a bit of a conversation with one another. Woodsy finishing in fourth spot. And everyone over the scales. Donnie Schott's weight correct. Don't forget, folks, we are back here Saturday night for round, I think it's round number six of World Series Sprint Cars, round number 5 of World Series Sprint Cars. So, like to see you back here on Saturday night for that. Full program of supports as well. And, of course, don't forget the 10th and 11th of January, of course, the Australian Open here at Ausdeck Patios and Roofing Archerfield Speedway. And, well, I don't know about you guys, but Donnie's the only guy. I don't know about you guys, but Donnie's the only guy I know that goes on holidays and goes home with more money than he came with.
Well, that's because he stays out of the casinos for a start, which is always good.
But, yeah, I got to say, I don't know about you, Mackie, you didn't probably see it, but Kevy's lucky to be on this podium.
Absolutely.
Man, smacked the wall hard a couple of times out of four there. The car was just not behaving the way it should have.
Tell you what, Joel Berkeley's done an outstanding job on the sicker kit here.
Yeah, absolutely. Car looks absolutely mint.
Tipman rolling across along with Andrew Shirley, and we will get presentations underway very shortly. Just waiting for the 10-time World of Outlaws champion to make his way out of the J&J and takes the harness off. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, 3 starts, 3 wins. Make some noise for Donnie Schatz. Another stellar driver, stellar win, and has made it look so easy. We're going to start with 3rd place. Hopefully we can get Kevy up as... Andrew Shirley up as quick as possible. And we'll swap mics over so you can do that.
Well, as he makes his way around, folks, put your hands together for 3rd place tonight in Andrew Shirley. Congratulations, Shills. Mate, Kevy got you on that restart, but, mate, she was a tough gig out there tonight.
Yeah, it was. I mean, Donnie was fast as usual. We got rolling pretty good. I guess I got in too slow on that last restart, which let Kevy get a run on me, and that was all it wrote. So, big shout out to the boys. Thanks, Graham and Gazza. Wife and kids upstairs, big fella upstairs for keeping us safe. Michael and Heather, his family are here tonight, I think Johnson, so it's cool to have them over from America. Big shout out to Donnie, he's just best of the best, isn't he?
Yeah, he certainly is. That's why we get him here, mate.
Yeah, it's exactly right. We all need to sort of lift our standard when he comes to town, but he's very good. Just big shout out to Castrol Edge, Ausdeck Group, Ian Boccia Race Parts, Royal Form Industries, you know, everyone that makes the car go round. Yeah, just a bit disappointing on that last restart, but anyway, we'll suck it up and we'll fix this thing up and weld some new front tubes in it and come back again on Saturday night, I think it is, and have another go.
Well, I was just about to say, were you going to put another frame together for Saturday night, but you just answered that question.
Well, we'll see how we go. Like, it's pretty beat up and, you know, like, we got some angle iron there holding it all together there on that left front corner. So, we'll either way, we're going to have to do something. So, that'll be a project for Graham over the next couple of days.
Congratulations on your 3rd, buddy. Well done.
Thank you.
Always great to catch up with Andrew Shirley. Ladies and gentlemen, home in 2nd spot, the showstopper, the boss man, Kevy Tipman. Mate, leading the ECL point score coming in tonight, still sitting on top just, but another bag full of points, always handy.
Yeah, we kind of struggled through the heats tonight, got lucky with the Pildra on the dash and tried a few things for World Series, put the car back to where it has been from when we won early in the season and off she went. We sort of struggled with the feature there, but dropped a couple of spots, Andrew passes and that, but found the bottom and working 1 and 2 and got rolling again and, you know, made a 2nd, so I'm pretty happy with that.
What a stellar couple of nights it's been.
Yeah, we kind of had a few things go wrong in those other meetings, but 6-4-2, so we'll take that and, you know, come back on Saturday, Sunday, Tuesday, Friday, Saturday, whatever it is, and go race hard against the big boys. So
there's a race you're coming.
I'm not going to lose more. I think we'll have
it.
No. No, we're good. Just like to thank Simon, Bobby, Jason, Henry, Big Brad, everyone that helps in the car, Brad Hilda, Maxwell Racing Engines, everyone's put in, Mum and Dad, John Chipman Racing. Congratulations, Donnie and Andrew. It was a good race. Unfortunate to Luke. I don't know what happened to him, but, you know, he was obviously pretty good tonight. So, see you on Saturday night.
Absolutely brilliant, mate. Great to catch up. Home in 2nd place, Kevy Tipman.
And we'll grab our winner, Donnie Schatz. And, Donnie, this 15 car, it seemed like from our vantage point, the longer this race went, the stronger the 15 got. Was that the case?
Yeah, it felt really good at the end. You know, it just took forever to get going there. We got traffic, and Luke got way out there, and I started hustling a little bit and got going, and we got to him there, but he got up on the cushion, and I don't know if he got biked or ended up hitting the fence. I'm not quite sure. And I tried to get out of there. I figured I was going to end up in it if I didn't get off the top. So, we just kept getting better and better and better. These guys rallied back. I knocked the birdcage off it in that heat race, and we didn't catch it for the dash. So we're lucky we didn't tear a whole bunch of stuff up. But they got it fixed. It's a real solid car. We keep playing with little things, and still don't feel quite like I should. But some days I think it's just me. So it's the way it goes. So thanks for everybody for being here tonight. It's a good way to start off 2020.
When we see guys bouncing around the high side, you said you went up there and then went back down to the bottom. Just how difficult was the cushion in it? It seems like whether it was the modified to the sprint cars, we saw a lot of guys kind of struggle to get around the high side of this place tonight.
Yeah, I don't know. You got to pick your battles. There's one thing I know. When I started that race, there was no way I could run 35 laps on the cushion pounding it like that. So you didn't see me trying. You know, I was trying to keep within distance and try to not put myself in a bad spot. And when I seen it going away from me, when he got out there, I started pushing a little bit and got myself back up there. But you're not going to hustle it like that. It's tricky. I mean, you seen what happened in 3 and 4 there. You get into it just right and just in the wrong spot, and you end up on two wheels or you know, end up slinging you up in there and hitting the fence. So nothing wrong with it. Just the way it is. You got, like I said, you got to pick your battles. And I kept trying to make the bottom work. I couldn't make it work. So I ended up there, but I had to be cautious. And that's what you do. That's why we drive these things. They're fun. If it was predictable, everybody'd be doing it.
Donnie Schatz, Eastern North Dakota, hockey territory. Hat trick for the 15 tonight. 3 for 3. Ozdex Patios and Roofing, Archerfield Speedway.
Absolutely brilliant night again, boys. Stellar job. Well done again to you, Blake Anderson. Learning so much off you, mate. It's been a fantastic night, and we have really entertained you the last few nights.
Oh, it's been fantastic. I don't know what more you could ask for. We had more great finishes tonight. Sprint cars, fantastic feature. We had drama with the Paul Britton 44 there, where lap traffic came into the mix and nearly had a last lap pass for the lead.